Please welcome firstly into the red corner, Shogan WESTCOTT. This fight card, please welcome boxing out of the red corner, representing the Box to Burn gym, Richard Collins, and his opponent across the ring, boxing out of the blue corner, representing the venue boxing gym, Shogan WESTCOTT. 3 2-minute rounds. Your referee, Mr. Colin Payne.
Well, Shogan WESTCOTT and Richard Collins head-to-head here. EWCB live in the house. Referee Colin Payne brings us together. I'm Danny Kendrick in the commentary box. It has been a long old day, and I'm glad you lot have joined us for all of it as well. It's been a pleasure to spend the day with you all. Viewing figures are huge, so I know I'm in good company at the moment. Head movement and the evasion already from the red. Shogan WESTCOTT, fast hands and finding his range now and starting to go to work.
Yeah, you've got real clash of styles here, haven't you?
Yeah, I mean, blue fighter WESTCOTT, he's rolling his head all over the place sometimes. He needs to just settle himself and lean back a little bit. Red coming forward with a quite uncomfortable stance for me, Richard. He's got his hands close to his head, but just sticking his face right in range, isn't he?
Yeah, I'm not a great fan of having one leg in front and then stepping forward with the other one either. I mean, keep one foot in front most of the time. Make a definite change if you want to, but don't change as you throw a punch.
Yep. Nice to tread through your punches when the time's right, but not in these situations at all, I agree. Shogun's starting to control this for me. Just wandering around and...
Well, he's weathered a bit of a storm.
I think if he got lively with that left hand, Richard, I think he destroyed his kid, didn't you?
Yeah, I think you're right.
There, he just needs to jab and control him. He's just finding his range. He's like a rangefinder, his left hand, isn't it? Oh, and then they turn around uncomfortably and lands a couple of punches as he goes on the run. There's nowhere to hide in here, sir. One of them rounds, Richard. One of them rounds.
Yeah, I think I'd have to, although I don't like his style personally, I think I'd have to give that to the red corner. More work, more techniques landed on target.
I think Shogan controlled that one for me. Like, he had him where he wanted, but he's so shy with that left hand, he's not scoring freely enough, you know. Just the situation and the range, the way he's got his hands pinned, you could take away all day with the left hand and set the right up. He needs to get lively for me.
Yeah, it's I suppose the thing that we don't know is what the criteria is for the judges. You've got one beside you there, Dan, give him a nudge and ask him.
Well, sometimes it's a luxury of a commentator to see the judges' scorecard on the sly, but...
He's keeping it well covered, yep, I can't see it
from here. He's very professional, this man. He's got it covered over all the time, so... I can't even see that. Don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, I said it before, back home, the judges' scorecard counts for nothing in this game.
I think you're wrong, Dan. I think the judges' scorecard counts for everything.
Sorry, the commentator's scorecard counts, and I think the judges' scorecard is imperative, of course. Oh, and here comes Red.
A Freudian slip there, Dan. I think you want the power.
I'd love the power. But one man can't do it all, Richard. Just good head evasion and stepping in now, red corner, and Blue's very uncomfortable when he puts the pressure on.
Yeah, you see, like I said about the last round, no points for style, no points for grace, but I would score it the last round for red just because he landed more techniques, in my opinion.
Now, let's see who the judges agree with here. He is punching away, isn't he? He's getting that left hand lands.
Yeah.
Blue, for me, does not fire enough shots. Even lightly with that left hand, you can see his range. He's going to... Look, there, he's it's like he doesn't want to punch him with it.
Yeah, he's got the range.
Oh.
He's got it completely sorted out.
Oh, Collins wants to punch him when he gets the chance.
Yeah.
Gunshy. Almost finding his range of left hand, keeping that right hand pinned and not firing it. He's waiting too long. And over 3 2-minute rounds, don't wait too long because it'll be over before you started.
Absolutely. You take two rounds to find your range. Doesn't matter how good your range is in the third round unless you can knock the guy out.
Oh, left hand finds the target.
Again.
And it wakes up, blue corner, and Westcott starts to throw punches.
See, I think the quality of his work is good. He's just not doing enough of it.
Yeah. He wants to control him. His footwork's good. He gets a good range, gets a good distance. But he's just so shy with that left hand. He's making hard work for himself.
Yeah.
Well, some stern talking to's in the break, and these two guys need to lay it. Good hook as he came up there in the red. Listen, it's not technically the most ingenious fight you're ever going to see, let's be honest, but it's got this crowd going absolutely wild behind us here.
Certainly has. Sometimes, you know, you can go to an event, you have two quality fighters up against each other. Neither one has sold any tickets. It's a brilliant bout and nobody cares. And then you get a fairly, you know, novice level bout like this with loads of people interested. It makes it exciting, doesn't it?
I think red corner Richard Collins has grown as this fight's gone on and upped his product all the time. He's starting to enjoy it a lot more in there. I think he's a little bit phased from the range of Westcott when this fight started. But I think Westcott's just been too shy with his punches. He didn't capitalise on it early, which has given Collins a great growing confidence, and now he's hunting him down, isn't he?
He is. He's catching him with loads of those overhand left.
There's that jab. If he follows that up and takes a couple of steps in, he'll land. It's going to be a red win, this.
Yes, oh. I think it is.
I don't know. Westcott's fighting like a man who's 9 rounds up.
Yeah, he's fighting like he's going to let it go soon.
I I think he's blown, to be honest, Rich. I think the energy's gone, yeah. I think he'll be happy to hear the end belt.
There it is.
Well, surely that goes down as a red corner win for Richard Collins, but like I said before, Richard, who am I to comment? I can only say what I saw. And there's three judges here who will have all seen a different fight to me as well. Or maybe the same fight. It's an accumulation of those three cards that will decide the winner here. Good support for the guys behind me though. And it's EWCB action. And once again, all in favour of the Amelia May Foundation.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three half-court rounds of Essex white collar boxing, your winner by unanimous decision in the red corner, Richard Collins. Come on. Well, ladies and gentlemen, fantastic challenger tonight, Shogan Westcott. Rolling straight on to bout number 19. Please welcome firstly into the red corner, Martin Beck.
A long, long time ago, I can still remember how that music used to make me smile. And I knew if I had one chance that I could make those people dance, and maybe they'd be happy for a while. But February made me shiver with every paper I delivered. Bad news on the doorstep, I couldn't take one more step. I can't remember if I cried when I read about his widowed bride. dry. Them good old boys were drinking whiskey and rye, singing this'll be the day that I die. This'll be the day that I die. Did you write the book of love? Do you have faith in God above? If the Bible tells you so, and you believe in rock and roll, can music save your mortal soul? And can you teach me how to dance real slow? Well, I know that you're in love with him, 'cause I saw you dancing in the gym. You both kicked off your shoes. Man, I dig those rhythmic blues.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome his opponent into the blue corner, Sean Tommy. Number 19 on the seniors fight card, and this contest is scheduled over 3 2-minute rounds of Essex white collar boxing. Boxing out of the red corner, representing the Spartans gym, and boxing in memory of his mum tonight, Martin Bear. And his opponent across the ring, boxing out of the blue corner, representing the Gateway Boxing Academy, Sean Tommy. Three rounds of boxing. Your referee, Mr. Colin Blaine. Thank you.
Well, here we go. Two friends give each other a hug, go back to their corners. It's Sean Tormey and Martin Beck. And it's time to go to war here at EWCB. Lively start from the red, who's very animated and looks like he wants to get on with this one.
Yeah, he was jumping around at the start, wasn't he?
Yeah, Tormey's laid him straight down with a right hand, though. It's a standing eight count straight away.
That was a good shot.
Oh, he's going to spoil this party. He's got a good support behind him here. They're all doing it in favour of a lady over there as well, who's sadly passed away.
To be honest with you, though, win, lose or draw, it won't make any difference to the tribute he's made to her. I mean, it's
no, of course not. No, you're right, Richard.
And it's a great gesture to do anyway, isn't it?
Yep. Oh, two double shots. He's frantic at the moment. And the right hand's landed again.
Yeah, he's going to get caught again. I can't see this going any time at all.
No, Tommy's put him down again. And it's not been a good day in the office. No, it's not been a good day in the office for Beck. Oh, very professional move there as well, ladies and gentlemen. Getting rid of that gum shield just to get a bit of extra time. But Colin Payne is a ruthless contender in the middle of that ring, and he's not giving it because he's called the end. He's hurt him. And well done for getting in there, sir. But it's not for everyone, a bit of boxing. I'll tell you, it's a lot harder when it gets in there. So don't criticise people when they're in there. they need to discover themselves and he's discovered it's hard in there, hard between the ropes, lad.
Boxers please to the centre of the ring. When you're ready, boxers. Ladies and gentlemen, again, an amazing bout tonight, raising plenty of money for charity. But ladies and gentlemen, in 1 minute and 15 seconds of the opening round, your winner, as the red corner have retired their boxer, as they're in no position to continue. Your winner in the blue corner, Saul Tormey.
I'll throw it back to you. By now, you should have somehow realized what you gotta do.